So good afternoon to everyone. First of all, it's my pleasure to say a big thanks to Shahnaz because she invited me and my husband here in this conference. And I consider that to every event that is organized in the memory of Lotfi Zadeh and before in honor of him, I want to be part of this event. So I try to have the occasion to be here. And fortunately, we have a project related to intelligent buildings. So we organize together with my husband, and we are here to be in this important event because Lotfi is still is our mentor and will be for the next future for sure. First of all, I prepare some words, so a few general words related to where is Romania and so on. I will start with my country. Maybe some of you know, some no, it's southeastern Europe, and also where is our city is located in the west side of Romania, near the Hungarian border, and this area is known as Transylvania. Transylvania, most of you knows about Dracula country. Arad, together with Timișoara and this region until the Danube, it's another region, the most rich region in Romania, named Banat region, where we have a mixed population, Romanian, Hungarian, German, Jewish, Croatian, Serbian, and so on. Our city is very near to Timișoara. Timișoara has a very famous Politehnica University where we studied and we prepare our PhD degree in electronics and telecommunication. Bucharest, our capital, is about 600 kilometers far from Arad, and Arad is more closer to other six capitals in Europe, so it's very easy to go to Budapest, to Wien, to Belgrade, to Bratislava, and so on, even to Zagreb. It's closer than Bucharest. We have, you can see, mountains, the Danube, Black Sea, and everything here. It's a very beautiful country. Some images from my city. In the center we have the city hall. Then we have Mureș River, who is the second river after the Danube, who is going through our big fortress in Arad, more than 300 years old, and also other buildings. Catholic and Orthodox Cathedral, and also the City Hall. Right side, it's our university auxiliary services, because we have the new building where we have 9 faculties and different other specialties. Here is the first meeting in Romania with Professor Lotfi Zadeh. First, we met in IPMU conference in Annecy in 2002, and then I proposed him to visit our country to offer him a PhD, honorary doctorate in 2003. He came in our university from another conference from Istanbul. He told me, you do not need to pay, I will come from another conference going at home and will stop in Arad. Here is the second meeting in my first edition of Soft Computing Application Conference, SOFA conference. I organized the first three editions in Romania and Hungary, thinking to be like a bridge between these two countries and to organize interesting meetings with people from both countries, but also from other countries. Here is the team that was involved in organizing It's about Anna Maria Varconicozzi, it's me and Janos Fodor. Also here is Josef Dombi and Imre Rudas from Obuda University. Here I can see another scientist from Israel, if I well remember. Also the same first edition. Here the same edition with our rector, Lizica Mihuț, who has a good meeting with Professor Zadeh. Here we are in Paris in 2006 to another conference, IPMEU. You can see here Irina Perfilieva and Professor Mamdani. Lotfi is with us. Here is the second edition of my conference that was organized in Gyula, Hungary, and in Oradea, north side of my city, together with our honorary chair, Professor Zadeh and Micio Sugeno. Here it's in 2008, last time when Lotfi came in Romania, it was a conference in Oradea, ICCC, very well known, and the journal, they are organizing a journal that is the best journal ICI in Romania in this domain. Here are some participants also from Oradea in 2008. Another meeting, it was in San Francisco in 2011, also together with our dear honorary chair of SOFA conference with Faye in the same place in 2016 in Berkeley. Together with Lotfi, together with the team from India, also with Lotfi during the banquet. And it's an image with our group that stay until the end. You can see friends who are participating here, and we were very happy to be together. It was the last time. And here I participate to Baku, to Lotfi funerai. I cannot stay at home, knowing that Baku is not so far from my country. Here is a journal that I am editing from 2008, and I'm very proud because the greetings in the first number was written by Professor Zadeh. This journal is Scopus only, but will be soon ICI. There are too many papers just now. More than 270 papers are waiting to be published, so maybe in 3 years they can be published. I increase the number, the issues every year. Now we have 12 issues per year. This is the, and it's important to say here that editor-in-chief together with me is Anca Ralescu from Cincinnati, and at this point I will stay a little bit because most of you know about Romanian scientists working in FASI, and you know very well about Anca Ralescu, Dan Ralescu, and Professor Negoiță, Constantin Negoiță. So, Ralescu Negoiță wrote the first book on FASI logic. It was FASI set in 72. After that, they emigrate and they had their activities in US. Ralescu family and also Professor Negoiță. There are also many groups in Romania that are working in FASI because we have in our curricula in every university FASI control, FASI neural and so on, all soft computing techniques. This is the second journal also in Inder Science where I'm editor in chief, and here you can see the proceedings to every edition. This year we will have the 8th edition, will be organized also in Arad. So these first two editions in 2005-2007, I have here collected the signature of Lotfi, here Lotfi and Micio also because they participated in these two conferences. Then 2009-2010, you can see a lot of signature of our invited speakers from even from Brazil, from US, from Japan, and so on. I published with IEEE, a Computational Intelligence Society. They were technical co-sponsor to my conference, but from 2012 I switched to Springer volumes. This is the edition that I organized in Szeged, and you can see the next edition, 2014, that was organized in Timișoara, in Polytehnica University, two volumes in Springer, and 2 years ago, also two volumes, the conference was organized in my city, in Arad. What I put here yesterday, but I had not enough time to organize and to see everything, it was a discussion on the group. You can recognize this group on artificial intelligence. So it was a problem related to determinism versus choice. And it was a problem introduced by Professor Zadeh, and Rich responded. Professor Zadeh proposed Valentina problem. What is the age of Valentina? And I asked him at that time if he was thinking to me, because he put many names, you can discover always. And he responded here, I use the liberty of using your name. It gives me pleasure to do so. So I was very honored seeing this discussion that was continued on this group. You can find it on internet, 2006, something, July, August. At the end of this presentation, I put this team because it's very, very important and dear to me, this team, Shahnaz and Sabina and Chimnaz, because they are backside of many conferences in soft computing, and I appreciate very much their activity. And everything that Shahnaz and their daughter was doing for Lotfi in the last years of his life. So without Shahnaz, very near to him, I think he cannot survive so many years. But thanks to her, not only me, but you all were also with Lotfi near, and maybe you discovered that even in his last speech, I remember his speech in 2016 in this conference, we discovered a lot of things that can be applied. And it was really a source of inspiration for all of us. This is also my university. And now, the presentation. Our team in Arad University, Aurel Vlaic University from Arad, developed during the years. We start to work in 93, and we start to work on fuzzy logic maybe 1 year after. And together with my husband, we had our PhD in Timișoara, Polytehnica University, of course, in this field, fuzzy logic, fuzzy control especially. I was involved in developing smart sensors with internal model and fuzzy techniques. Also, Professor Zadeh wrote the foreword of my book that was appearing after my PhD. And he wrote there that Professor Pister from here, from California University, Berkeley, introduced in that time, 2000, something like this, the so-called smart dust. So Lotfi was really a visionary, because he wrote in the foreword that the future world will be a world of a lot of sensors, chip sensors, that can give a lot of information And by fusing this information, you can obtain a more precise one. So I was interested in my doctoral thesis to organize such networks, it's like Internet of Things nowadays, to organize such sensors that can give good information for some intervals, but by an original method, fuzzy fusion technique, to obtain a good information such that this information can be used. Specifically, I developed two applications, one related to a sensor for an ABS system, the other one for a temperature sensor. But we were also interested in developing some application in greenhouses together with my husband. See, this I will continue in the presentation. And other interesting research was related to intelligent transportation, where we were interested to see how we can organize a platoon and to maintain the distance between two different cars. Also, together with my husband, we developed so-called criterion, time-to-collision criterion, very useful. We discover good citations. So, related to this presentation, you can see fuzzy control for rooftop greenhouses toward the green skyline cities. Here is the content that I will follow. As introduction, you can see that fuzzy logic is perfectly suited to cope with perceptions. And we have some applications that we develop related to air conditioning applications for temperature, humidity, air composition, especially for buildings. But first of all, we develop for railway coaches, because in our city we have the biggest plant for railway coaches in southeastern Europe. We also work in that factory for 8-9 years. So we work in industry and all our applications are from that direction in the first stage of our research. Some previous experiences with fuzzy control, because we are interested especially in fuzzy control, are air conditioning for railway coaches and greenhouses and passive greenhouses control. Here are some images, because we develop a lot of models for the railway coaches and also the model for the greenhouse that can be very easy used for an automobile and also for a building, for a room and so on. Of course, for a greenhouse that you can see in this figure. So these are MATLAB models. We have a lot of simulations, and we obtain very good results. In speaking about greenhouses, I can introduce here some elements, because it's about a passive greenhouse. Greenhouse do not use any electricity. Everything is obtained from renewable energy, from wind generator, from solar panel, and we use also heat pumps. In the same time, fuzzy logic is perfectly suited to cope with complexity, and we are studying now this concept of green skyline city. This topic is also interesting for us, because nowadays we are speaking about smart cities, what to do, and this is a component. Also, we have very active students, and we are organizing them in teams. And just now, a team is competing in a national competition related to this topic. So, green roof cities It's an interesting concept, and maybe you saw it, because nowadays this concept can be observed that were introduced some many years ago, and just now we must do something, because our cities are very crowded, and the technology involved that involve oxidation, overwhelming CO2 footprint, obvious effect in atmospheric composition, the CO2 growing, and oxygen depletion. So everything is increased the global greenhouse effect. Also, the complementary natural phenomenon that is capable to compensate oxidation is photosynthesis. Our metabolism and comfort require the presence of plants. We need to inhale plants produced oxygen, while plants need CO2. So, we need a last symbiosis with plants. Conventional plant cultivation is 2D usually, because we have field, we have parks, we have even greenhouses. Because the space resources have become very limited, we are moving now to 3D approach. So green roof buildings can be a good idea. This green roof building replaces conventional roofs by rooftop greenhouses. It was this topic introduced. Such way we can turn our cities into large cultivation area on the top of the blocks. The main technical challenge, the joint management of energy and water for buildings in this concept. So these two are very interested for us. These rooftop greenhouses have been introduced many decades before, more than 50 years before, by Arbor House, by Dexus in New York. And we are revisiting this concept. Making it sustainable, environmentally friendly, and extendable over the entire city, if possible. Linking this concept with building's ventilation system implements the human-plant symbiosis. So the plant over the roof, they need carbon dioxide that we can introduce by a ventilation there in the roof. And the oxygen they offer, we can use inside the building. Also, some features of green roof buildings are heating, cooling by renewable energy we can use there. So the air that is warm, upper side, can be introduced by the ventilation inside the apartments. Such a way we can speak about renewable energy that can be used. Multifunctional water system, so collecting rainwater, it's a problem in some cities, collecting and treating buildings' wastewater, storing energy. Such a concept is complicated, is nonlinear, is highly nonlinear, and very slow. So we must do it intelligent. How to do to obtain an intelligent system? Here it's a paper published by a team together with my husband and a professor from Germany. It's about expert control for the coupled tanks greenhouse. Here is that building that I introduced related to Nexus. So there are such buildings in many places in US. I studied on internet quite in every city. I will try to be faster. So this concept is associable with two basic concepts, intelligent house and the passive greenhouse. Intelligent control, we have some component here. Intelligent control, intelligent of things, internet of things, smartphone monitoring, related to intelligent house. You can see here this concept of intelligent house. A lot of application on mobile phones that can control different things in a house. Here, I said it's combined with passive greenhouse. We introduced this concept, I explained earlier. So some specific solutions we intend to use are liquid desiccant air conditioners, more specifically water G concept, and then couple tanks system. Only a few figure here related to the greenhouse, because we are working much more in greenhouses. So we have this here, a heat pump and two reservoir, upper side and underground, warm water and cold water, and we can exchange this. Doing this, we can produce heating or cooling inside the greenhouse. On the other on the other side, we can see for the other process. So here it's warm water, on the other side is cold water. And also this is about two streams ventilation systems. So we need to have these streams to introduce the air with oxygen inside the apartment, and carbon dioxide from the apartment to introduce upper side for plants. Here are different concepts for greenhouses. This is Venlo greenhouse that was developed by Dutch, and it's the well-known model. It's very robust, and the model is there, and everything is very well known. This is a vertical greenhouse that you can find in Singapore. This is a photovoltaic greenhouse, also a Dutch one, and this is a Fresnel greenhouse that use some lens upper side, and here you can see some sensors that collect the infrared radiation and use it to produce energy. There are different possibilities to use this kind. This is another kind of greenhouse, LED greenhouse, that use LED, color LED inside to offer to the plants the light that they need to grow. This is another concept, it's a FiviHex greenhouse. It's a more complex one. You can see here sub aquifer with different level of water, warm water, cold water. Also, this place can be used to introduce all the remaining plants to obtain at the end some gas. So this gas can be stored in some recipient, and the whole greenhouse can have enough energy to work. This is a project that we, our team introduced as a project, Horizon 2020. It was introduced, but with a consortium of 11 universities. They work very, very hard and prepare everything for a greenhouse that can use all these facilities in Morocco. Here there are different concepts. Even you can see some reservoirs with fish. They can produce fish, but more impressive and interesting is that can be put near the seaside, so the salt water can be introduced in the greenhouse, but by vaporization process the salt can be take out, and the water can be used for the greenhouse. Unfortunately, this important project was introduced somehow at the end. It was rejected exactly in the last moment, but we prepare it for the next call. Here we have how to control the green roof building system. We combining all these systems that I have introduced here. We have here in the robust greenhouse optimal control, and here soft computing is used. Here is our experimental model that we have in our university with those tanks. I will not explain too much how to move the water from the warm to the cold. Here are some rules. I put only as examples. So we are using such systems to control, taking into account all the parameters that we are interested in. Some advantages are here and impact, yes. Here is the last slide. And you can see that this concept of green sky cities is a good one that can be represent the future of the smart cities in terms of water and in terms of comfort and in terms of new jobs that can creating and many others that are introduced here in this slide. So this project was supported by a contract with the economical environment in our region, is related to intelligent buildings. Thank you very much.
It's a very interesting project. I just, in support of it, I just wanted to mention that in El Paso, we have, it's a desert, so we don't need a greenhouse. But we do have, on top of our biological sciences building, we do have plants, and it actually follows the example, like my parents were born in, my father was born in Uzbekistan, and there in the villages, they often grow things on the roof. The advantage is not only you get additional crop, but you get cooling in summer. I don't know why, honestly, it's kind of physics beyond me, but same thing in this biological building. They saved a lot of money on having this plants on the top because you don't need to use air conditioning that much. Okay, thank you very much.
Yes, but we can put such greenhouses in the top of the mountains, in the desert, everywhere, because it exists also the concept of closed greenhouse. So the water remains there. In terms of efficiency, it's demonstrated that these solutions that I introduce here are feasible.
Do you study the impact of greenhouse in large scale? For example, will it reduce temperature or environment? Because you have more greenhouse, you know, all these plants absorb energy, so the temperature may drop.
Yes, the temperature will drop. Even outside, because we do not have some process of oxidation or some process that need fire to produce energy, because we will produce inside this greenhouse using renewable energy, using, you saw a lot of new facilities that offer the technology. So it's a concept for the future,
so
for sure. In put this greenhouse over the top of the block, maybe you are thinking so, we can recirculate because we have a ventilation system that can use the air from inside to put down. It's okay. And I have only one comment, because I remember your comment at the end, Professor Chang, related to transistors. I cannot stop, and I want to say something. So you said that we attain the limit. Now the transistor, it's 7 nanometers. We cannot go down. Do you agree? We attain the limits. More.
You mentioned that.
Yes, 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 yes. But nowadays in US, in Europe, people are working on such project like Brain Initiative that was launched by President Obama in 2013. We are working just now, is not yet fuzzy, but will be soon fuzzy, even in our project where we are working. It's a biocell nanoart. It's a project, 3 million euros in our university. We are working with Professor Valeriu Beiu, who is our principal investigator. I am the director of work package for software, my husband for hardware, and there are also other work packages. What is happening nowadays? If we will continue with this consume for computer systems, data center computers and so on, in 2040, we will not have enough energy for our computing systems. Do you know this? And nowadays, there are so lot research in this domain to find a new technology. Maybe transistor and semiconductor will not be an option for the few years that will come. And our team is working in modeling such systems and to obtain new devices for the future that have low power consumption and high reliability. How to do this? We are trying to copy a neuron. Neuron is the same level like a transistor nowadays, 7 nanometers, a little bit down. And we are studying why the neuron is so reliable and the brain is consuming only 20 watt hour. How to do this? Because in such condition, if we can copy the brain, our mobile can be charged one time every 4 years. And we are working just now in modeling, in some simulation, using ion pumps, not semiconductor. That's all. Thank you very much.